So I've just received all the login data for my Contabo server. So what I got are the IP address, server type, the VNC IP and port. So VNC can be used to access your server remotely, and then the VNC password as well. And then you're going to get the username, and the username by default is root, and you're going to get a password for the root user and the type of operating system that you set up. You're going to get all of this in your Contabo first email. So if your account is new, you're also going to get your Contabo login details, and you can use that to log into your Contabo dashboard. We want to log into our server, and now that we have all the details, we can do that. We are interested in VPS control because we did set up a VPS. If you don't know which IP address you're working with or which is which, just go to your email address and look at the IP address that has been sent there. So you'll see the operating system. And if you're not sure, you can also come here under services. All right. So if you want to log into your server, the first thing you want to do is make sure that you restart your server. So the server will be restarted. And as soon as you do that, give it some time and just copy this, our IP address. We have the IP address, we have the user, our user is root, and we have the password that was sent for root. And you can find that in your Contabo email. To log in, so on Windows, I'm going to use Git Bash. You can download Git Bash for free and install it. If you are on a Mac or Linux, you can use Terminal to follow along. So just search for Git, if you're on Windows, that is, search for Git, download, and then click on that. You want to download it for Windows. Since you're on Windows, you're probably following along on Windows. Choose Windows and install it. And once you install it, it's going to come with everything we need. And we're going to use Git Bash for this tutorial. Once you install it, just come back to Windows and then search for Git. We want to work with Git Bash. You can see there's Git GUI and there's Git CMD, but I only want to use Git Bash. To log in, type SSH, and the user is root at the IP address. So with this, I think you can paste. Let's see how you can paste. That is at root at, and then you can paste, and you can do shift insert to paste. And as soon as I do that, it's going to ask me for the password. And you can see it's asking me to authorize this into my host's file. I'm going to type yes to affirm that. And it will be added to my host's file. So it will be a known host on my computer, and I can access it without any problems. We need to add the password. So you can paste it in here by doing shift insert. If you just do that, you can paste using shift insert, yes. And you won't see the password as you type it in or as you paste it in. So just press enter. And if it is correct, you should be logged into your server. There we go. That's how to log into your Contabo server. Of course, the first thing you want to do is you want to update your server. So since we are still using root, I can just do apt update, enter. Let's see if there are any updates. All right, so you can see 4 packages can be upgraded. So let's do apt upgrade to upgrade, enter. Then y, enter. So just let it update, and that will be pretty much it. So you've seen how you can set up your Ubuntu server on Contabo and then log into your Ubuntu server VPS. If you want to start setting it up. So just remember that we are going to start using this post to set up our server. So there we go, our updates are done. If you want to log out of your server, you can just do exit. And that's going to log you out of your server, okay? So let's continue in the next video. And in the next video, what I want us to do is, I want us to come in here and we are going to create a new sudo user. The link to this post is in the description. There we go. We're going to do this in the next video.